Christy Rachel. You always accuse me of cheating on you, and now one day you have caught me. Even if I know I'm cheating on you, why can't you give me the credit at least for respecting you at it and not rubbing it in your face?
I don't have to catch you. I can smell it, and my heart tells me that you're cheating. So there's no respect whatsoever in cheating. It's not because you respecting me or whatever you're saying that making you to hold back. It's because you know exactly what I would do if I just catch you.
Your instinct is fully dear. I do everything to prove that I love you. Not for anything in this world I'm going to cheat on you. In fact, when last have you called me a hard dinner? When?
And when last you came home dinner hours? When? Dinner hours 6 o'clock, 7 years, not 12 midnight. 12 midnight is time to sleep, not time to eat.
I don't think that's the issue, probably. You don't even know how to prepare 50 meals, that's it?
You're damn right. And you're not gonna eat a damn thing in this house. Not now, not anytime soon.
Okay, while are you at it? I'm moving to the guest room. You can find yourself a new sleeping partner.
Go! That's all you can do, coward. You can't even stay for a fight with a woman.
Yeah, hello. Hey, Nadia, what's up? At least you should have called to have us informed. That's okay. Sure, Mia is also here too. Okay, bye.
Lisa, I have a serious problem with Nadia. I really think she's giving herself too cheap to cruise. That guy has something up his sleeves that will get Nadia into frustration. Their relationship just seems too good to be true. Now trust me, when a relationship is that good, the destruction is this wide.
Why are you crying more than a bereaved?
Because the bereaved has tears in her eyes and she can't even see it.
You know your problem? It's jealousy complex. The tiny monster in you called jealousy is eating you up.
Jealousy? Wow. Jealous about what?
Think about how you're going to get your own boyfriend instead of worrying about your friend here and there.
I don't need a boyfriend. I can't seem to love anyone as much as I love myself.
Whatever. I'm late for class.
You know your problem? You know better than Nadia.
Rachel. You are my personal friend. And I need you to understand that you are taking it too far with your deal. Too far. Seriously, girl, you need to slow down. Or else, this guy might do something stupid. Most men are not trusted. Yeah, we all know that. But you can't keep accusing this guy based on mere assumptions. He's a man. You might end up pushing him to the curbs.
Sweetie, I know my man. In fact, I know most men. I've been there and I've done that. And my past relationships made it clear to me that you can't trust them. You have to calm down really hard on them. And it's because of my action towards Fidel that's making him to hold back a little. Simple mistake, I'm out. So, I can't risk losing my man right now.
Hi,
Michelle. Hi, baby. How's the day going?
Oh, it's going great.
So, he has to give me some guarantee. Until he can put a ring on this, I'm not cooling off.
Fine. But your attitude might make him leave the house.
Take it from someone who butt hurts 1,000 times from hitting the floor. It's for the birds. He can never leave the house. My man loves me, and he knows I'm only protecting my relationship.
Okay, sweetheart. Just trying to advise you.
Highly appreciate it.
So, where's school? How was the party yesterday?
Oh, it was fantastic. They had good food and cool games. And I took some pictures.
Pictures?
Yeah.
Let me see them.
Okay. Wow. It was funny, huh? Okay.
Nadia, why are you crying?
Come on, sweetie, talk to us.
It's Cruz. It's Cruz. Can you imagine? Cruz asked me to go to his house. When I got there, I met him in bed with another woman trying to talk to him. Cruz asked me to leave. Cruz asked me to leave.
You see what I used to tell you about that guy? You are going too fast, Nadia. Now look what you've done. He's made an ass out of you and you're sitting here crying.
Why are you laughing?
Because today is April 1st. I'm just kidding with you girls. My Cruz can never, ever cheat on me.
And what makes you think Cruz can never, ever cheat on you?
Because with the time we've spent together and the amount of money I've invested in Cruz, Cruz can never think about doing such a thing to me. I've played my position well as a woman to keep her man, and that position is secured.
Nadia, money cannot buy love. So stop spoiling your late father's money on that guy.
That's true. But money can maintain love, and money can make love. And me and Cruz were keeping it cool just like that.
Why didn't you tell me you were chasing criminal in this town for 2 months? I watched it on television today.
Oh, come on, baby. It was due to security reasons, so I could not disclose that.
Okay, then. I think I shouldn't tell you that I'm 2 weeks pregnant.
What? You are not serious, are you?
Yes, of course. Why would I joke or something like this?
So, why didn't you let me know earlier?
Well, let me see. Due to some security reasons, I guess.
Well, due to security reasons. Well, I don't want you to do anything in this house. All right? Anything you want, just let me know. I get it for you. Wesleyan! Wesleyan!
Yes?
Please come over. Wesleyan? I don't want you to allow my wife to do anything in this house. You know why?
No.
Because she's carrying my baby boy.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, can I leave now?
Oh, yeah.
Who told you that it's a boy?
Oh, come on, baby. No, I put that baby.
Great American politician once said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country."
Yeah, I remember that. That was John F. Kennedy. And so?
So, I'm asking not what you can do for me, but what I can do for you in order to maintain this relationship.
So, what do you think you can do to maintain this relationship?
First off, I'm gonna tap up your bank account, and then I'm gonna change that old ugly car of yours. I think that's the best I can do as a girlfriend to maintain my man.
Stupid. Tell me you're kidding.
No, babe, I'm serious. I'm dead serious. Look, Cruz, I know you work and all that, but your salary is just chicken change. It's not even enough for you, let alone me, to take care of me, you know? The salary can, so I want to help you. That's the best I can do for my man, and I'm going to do everything in my power to help you.
Thank you so much, babe. I left the engine running. I just came to see what you would do if I gave you a chance to make things right. So I made it, even though Katie told me that this would be nothing but a waste of time. And she was right.
Say that again.
Man, I'm deadly serious. That girl tapped my account yesterday with $35,000. Guess what?
What?
I'm getting a brand new car tomorrow.
Well, my wish is that I wish Nadia knew a little of what she needs to know.
Come on. Nadia knows to maintain a good-looking man like me, it takes a whole lot. So,
well, if that's what you believe. Come on, man. You look like
a big mess. I'm in a big mess. Serious one.
What's that?
My secretary is pregnant for me.
What?
Stop playing, man. My secretary is pregnant for me. And don't even ask me how I manage. Because I still can't get over it. Wow. So, what are we gonna do right now?
Rasha is the cause of this. She pushed me into this. If she had not forced me that night, I would not have been out there.
No.
Man, I mean, how did that happen?
Man, I'm very nervous about that.
I didn't even know how to break the news to Rasha.
Man, that's your own case, alright? I mean, I stuck my neck down for you. So, just count me out.
Man, you're in a real mess. And Rochelle's gonna kill you.
And she might even come after us. It's serious. I mean,
that's
that
true.
Girl is hard. So, I don't know. Just get to my office.
Well, you know, if what you're saying is true, then you don't have to worry. This country is a country of law and justice, right? So, if you have the evidence, I mean, you just present it in the court, and if you are not guilty, you will be set free. Yeah. You see, I don't know why you guys from other countries look at Liberia to be. Yeah. Yeah, if you have a document, you can just present it in the court, and then if you are not guilty, you will be set free. So, that's all I can do.
Yeah, what's up?
So you told Nadia about what we discussed?
No, I didn't tell. I was kind of busy last night.
Cruz, like I always told you, you know, we are human. But when it comes to handling things, we do handle it differently. So, my fear is that if Nadia gets to know before you tell her, then I mean, someone might end up losing their life. Desperate women are so unpredictable.
I know, but man, it's so embarrassing right now.
My brother, nothing is embarrassing. Just do what you have to do.
Go now. We're just about 2 hours away from the office. So.
Well, before you leave, there's a breaking news.
What is it?
My wife is totally.
months pregnant.
Wow, that's like the father.
Wow, you can say that again, you know.
Nadia?
Yes?
Did you know Cruz was in the States before?
No.
And I think you should check it out.
What concerns me about that? Look, Maron, there is no way in this world you'll find a man 100% okay. I don't care in the States whether he was a robber, a thief, a terrorist. I do not care. I love my man. And I don't like the way you hit on my man. I really, really don't.
Sorry.
Being late, so what's up?
Yeah, better late than never.
Yeah.
So, what can I get you?
Nothing, I'm okay.
See, Chanel, the reason I called you here is to explain things to you about what transpired between the both of us. I mean that. This pregnancy that you're carrying is not in the right seat in season. I say this to say that I want you to delete that pregnancy or clear it up. And that's why I called you.
Mister, with all due respect, I'm not going to remove this under any pressure. And besides, this child I'm carrying is my first child. So, please erase that from your mind.
Chanel, do you know the implication in doing this? Do you know the aftermath my girlfriend gets to know about this? Look, I need you to save me from this. Please.
I can see that you only care about you and your girlfriend, right? But do you also know the implication in doing this? It caused a whole lot of things.
Chanel, I know death is on your mind. You won't die. I need you to do this if you still have love for me. I take God to beg you. Please.
Sir, if you don't mind, I have somewhere to go. This place is nice though, but I don't like being here. Excuse me.
Chanel, sit down.
One month now since you completed your so-called mansion. Aren't you gonna move in? What you do?
Look, I'm planning something. I want to send for my mom and other relatives. Matter of fact, it will be my mom's birthday.
Cruz, you have such plans without telling me?
Nadia, I'm sorry.
Anyway, I think that would be the best time for the engagement party.
Engagement?
Yes. All our immediate family member will be here. Or you don't have interest in getting married to me anymore?
No, I want to marry you, but just give me some time. I'll think about it and get back to you.
For the safety of you and Fidel, alright? Fidel loves you. And you don't mind you having a kid for him, alright? But if you do this, the DNC that we're talking about, if you do this, I personally will give you $10,000 US. Joel will give you $10,000 US. And Fidel will give you $15,000 US. With that, you have $35,000. And you can take a 1 year leave. And go anywhere. Please.
You see, Chanel, we do understand your point, you know, about us asking you to abort your first child. You know, but I want you to know that you are doing this because you want to help Fidel out of this whole stuff. And you know, putting your life on the line in order to settle his problems. I believe he's a man and he has conscience. He will develop some kind of love for you. You know, so for short, I'm kindly asking you to please just accept and abort the child. Please.
Mr. Joe Thomas, CRD Director, the Republic of Liberia. Mr. Cruz Brown, Managing Director of one of the world's largest humanitarian organizations. And as for you, Fidel Williams, I'm ashamed of you guys. Most especially, Joel Thomas, who took oath to protect lives and property. You are here asking me to kill my baby. What if I die in the process?
Well, Chanel, I've seen a lot of girls all around who have done the DNC, and they're still alive around here.
If you guys keep embarrassing me, I'm gonna publish you to the print media. Excuse me.
I'm sorry, there's nothing we can do. I don't want my name to be published in any newspaper.
I continue to say this. Rachel is the cause of this whole thing. She pushed me into this. If not forcing and fighting, we would have been okay. I can't even remember the last time I had dinner at my own house.
For real?
Anytime after 6, there's no food.